We're coming down to the Yukon River here. Starting to see it ahead in the distance. Wow, look at it winding up around that way. Recreational area, next left. Check it out, guys, here it is. Let this truck up here cross. Check it out. Yukon River says don't park on the side of the bridge. And that's what I'm doing. All right, so here we are riding across the Yukon River Bridge. It all made of wood. Check out that river. That river is huge. Wow. This bridge is hard to ride on. It's kind of uneven. So we're gonna go over here and get something to eat. Some gasoline. Can't believe we made it. Park right here. How's that? Now let's go in and get something to eat. Huh? Yeah. Check out this old camper. Old Dodge camper. Pretty cool. Yeah, we're about ready to leave. Stopped and had lunch. Had a cheeseburger and she had a club wrap. Everything still looks good. We got fuel right up here. That's the fuel you get here. So we're gonna go over here to the visitor center and check that out. So we're leaving the Yukon River camp and headed north. Here we go. Koyukuk Mining District. Sweet. We decided to take a little break, figure out what we're gonna do since some roads are all muddy, and we pulled down here to get in some shade. And look at this, talk about a smorgasbord of berries. Look at all these berries. Just blueberries, cranberries. Tell they're having a hard time in that mud. More coming. Tim, was they looking for us? There's the other bikes. Careful, buddy. He started to wave and looked like he almost got loose. I think that's why they call it Finger Mountain, that point sticking up way over there. Uh-huh. There's the bike. That's the way we're going next. It says the rock that juts from this landscape tell of a time 110 million years ago when magma oozed from through cracks in the bedrock. As the magma cooled, it became hard granite. Finger Rock, the largest tor in this area, stands 40 feet above the surrounding landscape. Wow. Throne, she said. This is the other side of the hill. Over there's the Koyukuk River. Wow, this is crazy. There's people out with their four-wheelers. Oh, look at this down here. Like a little river access. So does this just go here and stop? Kind of looks that way, huh? Nice looking river. Oh, here, we can go down this way. You hanging on? All that deep gravel. Let's jump off and look around. Man, we're sitting here having dinner, and I looked up on this ridge up there, and you can see one little point standing out up there. I think it's Bigfoot. What are you laughing about? Let's make some calls and see if we can call him down here, offer him some chicken. Yeah, I couldn't live in something this small. No, no, no. This tent is made for one person, and that's it. Ooh, the next morning, and boy did we freeze our butts off. I swear it got down into the 30s last night. Woke up today and it's a real foggy morning. Basically was up off and on all night long, fighting to survive and stay warm. Just got woke up by these guys down here loading a boat in the water. Looks like they're gonna go moose or caribou hunting. He keeps getting the boat stuck because the river's so shallow. But look how foggy this is. It's like some kind of crazy. I expect to see a T-Rex come running through here. Okay, so I knew it got cold last night. Look at the frost on my saddlebags and the ice on my seat. Look at that. That's ice. These things just about walked right up on us. Like they're just walking down the river trying to get around us. Yeah, it's moose season. Well, I'm glad they didn't come through last night while we were sleeping in the tent. They might not have saw us. I was curious where they were going. Look at him fighting through that current. I mean, he's got white water going up around his legs. Look at that. That's cool. That one's up out of the water. Shake it off. We're just looking at these mountains. Check out these mountains. That one there looks like it's a pyramid. And then there's another one behind it. Kind of crazy. Getting ready to have breakfast, having some scrambled eggs and ham. And we went ahead and took down camp. Tell you, that was a bad night's sleep. We should have worked on getting that a lot more level and smooth. But oh well, it got down to freezing last night, so the rocks weren't our only worry. But so anyways, we're running the sluice box a little bit today before we take off. Look at the trees across there. You can see fall's coming. Look at the yellow. And we're going to prospect around here for a little bit and then get ready to head back to Fairbanks this afternoon. Well, I've pretty much been using the bike for everything, hanging clothes on it, storing stuff, shade. Now, when you go camping in Alaska, you'll see these birds. They're called, we call them gray jays, or camp robbers, because they're so used to people that they'll just fly right on in. And I put a Pop-Tart out there for them. Make their day. They can't carry them. Exciting stuff. Helicopter's going over. Out in the middle of freaking nowhere. Well, Mr. Helicopter's coming back. There he is. He was buzzing the ridges and stuff. It's probably tourists taking a helicopter ride, and they're filming me while I'm looking up and filming them. I bet you that's what's going on. Still working the sluice box and just having a blast out here north of the Arctic Circle in Alaska. All right, well, I guess it's time to go home. I got the WR250R all loaded up. Check that out. That is a load. Emptied out about 2/3 of my gas can, so got enough gas now to get me back to the Yukon River Bridge and get some more gas there. So let's go ahead and ride out. My wife walked ahead because she didn't want to ride on this crazy stuff.